everyone. Welcome. I'm Davey Killian, and I have my first garage sale haul of the season. As many of you know who have followed me, I love thrifting and garage sailing. So we went yesterday garage sailing, and I'm going to share some of the items I got, as well as a few tips and tricks and rules that I abide by when garage sailing. So here we go. All right, the first few items I got are for two of my nieces. They are super cute little aprons, and they were marked $2 a piece, and I got both of them for $1. So one of my tips is to be able to bargain, and that has helped me save lots of money when I go out garage sailing. So I got two for $1 instead of $4, so saving money there. All right, another item I got were some golf tees. Now, another tip I have is to look for things you need. This has been, I am a golf coach, so tees are something I need. This has been something I've had to work on because I do like to buy things that I just like. And that's okay too, but it's good to find things that you know you will use and need in your house or for a project or for things like my students need golf tees. So just look for things that you know you will need. That way you're not tempted to just spend lots of money on items that will just sit around in storage or things you don't really love. And this was $2, but I also got it for $1. Again, being able to bargain. Okay, I did only get one more item, and this is a clothing item. It is time for me to cycle back through my clothes for teaching. I do this kind of once or twice a year because I just need to reevaluate what I have, what is going out of style. And I got this dress. It is a Banana Republic. It has, it's sleeveless, and it has a slight scoop neck and green and white striped. It's really cute. I tried it on, so it fits well, which is perfect. It was $3 originally, and I got it for $2 is what I asked for it. And another tip I have with that, have your money in hand. When they see that you have your cash out, they'll be like, sure, why not take it? So just have the money physically shown so that they can see you are willing to pay right then, right there, just the $2 you have. Another tip and rule that I kind of abide by is look deeply. So some things may not look very appealing with how they have it arranged, but you might find a treasure in the bottom of that box that you have been looking for and needing or wanting. And lastly, go ahead and go the last day of the garage sales. Two of them that we went to yesterday were 50% off everything. I know a lot of times people say go the first day, but when you go the last day, they often mark things half off or buy one, get one free or something like that. So you are saving money that way. And I guess then if you don't go the first day, you surpass things you maybe are tempted to buy but you don't really need. So that is my small little garage sale haul. I will be having more, hopefully weekly, for you. So give it a thumbs up if you like garage sales. Don't forget to subscribe as well if you haven't yet, because I will be doing these, like I said, weekly, and you don't want to miss some of the fun finds that we'll have. I hope you have a blessed and wonderful day. Bye. I also wanted to show you this item. These are nesting tables that my husband and I actually found for free. They are from IKEA, and original price was $200, and we found them in the dumpster, gonna be tossed out, brand new, never opened, from in the box. So yes, it's a little bit older model, but oh my goodness, to find these free, and I just can't believe the score that we got off of this. Like, how cool to get free nesting tables. So again, just look through junk sometimes to find treasures, like I had said earlier.